Hi there, my name is Katie Geddes and I am an online music studio owner and a teacher business coach. In today's video, I will talk about how to create a worksheet, a Canva for teachers tutorial. These worksheets can be used in the classroom, teaching online, or even selling them on Teachers Pay Teachers. If you are interested in creating a Teachers Pay Teachers store, then make sure to grab my Teachers Pay Teachers cheat sheet that I will link in the comments below. Let's get to it. So to get started, you are going to head to canva.com. If you don't have an account, go ahead and make one because you're going to need to in order to create your first project. So to get started, you can go ahead and check out your template. So let's go over to the left side, scroll down and click where it says templates. And this is going to open a bunch of pre-made worksheets and everything that you can imagine that Canva has created in order for you to, you know, use to get started or to gain inspiration from all the things. If you're planning to use these worksheets to sell on a platform like Teachers Pay Teachers, then that is totally possible. If you're new to creating your Teachers Pay Teachers store, then definitely make sure to check out this video next, which is all about how to start your Teachers Pay Teachers store. So, once you've explored these to your liking, you can come up to the top, click the right little bar right here and click where it says education, and they're gonna filter out everything that is non-education related. Once you've explored these as much as you want to, you can come over here to the left side and click down here where it says education and open these up to find some more options. So we're gonna go ahead and click where it says worksheet. It's going to pull up a bunch of worksheet templates in the education category that you can use for inspiration. So let's say that I really like this one. I'm going to click on it and it's going to ask me if I want to use it. I click on customize this template and it'll open up in another tab. It'll make it automatically a new file that you have in your library on your Canva account. And once it loads, you'll have the option to edit everything that we have here. So of course you can click on the text here. You can double click on it and you can change whatever it says. So we could say parts of the guitar. Of course, if you want to scroll in, you can click down here and drag this in so we can scroll up and see things a little bit better. Maybe we put our directions here. So I say label the parts of your guitar below with the vocabulary we learned in our lesson. All right, perfect. So you could do your name. Maybe you want to change this to something else like date. And you can leave those there. I don't love this little background, so maybe I could change this. I might delete this, change that to no color. I just click the delete button. If I wanted to change it to a different color, I could come up here and just choose one of my favorite colors that I have saved. I have these saved over here because I have the Canva Pro account. So if you have Canva Pro, you actually are able to put all of your brand boards over here. So you can save your colors, you can save your fonts for easy access. If you want to gain access to hundreds of photos, videos, audio, illustrations, icons, graphics, all the things, then make sure to click the link below for 1 month free of Canva Pro. All right, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and just keep this as white so it's easy for people to just print it out. And we could leave this if it related to your niche, you could leave that, but I'm actually gonna go ahead and just delete all of these because I want to add in a bigger text box. So maybe I'll keep one of the squares but delete everything else. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click, hold down, and it's gonna allow me to select everything at once. And then if I wanna deselect things, I can click shift, and then slowly deselect things one by one. So let's just deselect one of these square boxes and then whatever this background is. Then I'll click delete, everything goes away, and then I can make this bigger. So maybe I'll center it and then I'll make this side larger, I'll make the bottom larger, this way larger. Perfect, it's even a little bit too big. Okay, nice, so then I can center it. Canva is really great about giving you tools to position very well. You can also go up to these dots, click position, and you can center things. You can put them in the middle of your worksheet, but since I have that title, I actually don't really want to do that, so I'm going to undo. Nice. Okay, wonderful. So then I could come over here and I could add some elements. So if I come over here and I type in something related to my niche, let's say I type in guitar, and then I can go over to graphics. And I can choose from any of these graphics I have here. I'm gonna stick with my kind of black and white theme so that it's easier for this to be printed. So let's stick with this guitar. It's pretty simple, but it'll do. So I'm actually gonna turn it on its side like this. If you wanted to with graphics, you can also flip your graphics. You can do it horizontally, you can do it vertically, whatever you want. I'm gonna leave mine the way it is, of course, because it didn't make a huge difference. And then I'm gonna make it bigger. Nice, and then I'll put it over a little bit. Okay, awesome. So let's go ahead and put some lines here with some arrows that reference different parts of our guitar. So I'll do that by just going to elements again. And it's very simple. If you just scroll down, it has lines and shapes. So I'm just going to click on one of these lines and I can adjust how thick the line is. So I can make the line weight smaller. I can also make it a dotted line if I wanted to, instead of a just, you know, one solid line like that. And then I can click away and it will adjust my line as I want it. Oops, I added two. Okay, nice. So I can also make it shorter. So let's do it about that size. And now I'm going to press Control Copy and Control Paste. So that's Control and C, Control and V, or Command C, Command V. And then I'm going to move these all around and just add a few different options. Paste it again. Okay, nice. We're not going to do a ton of them, but let's just do a few. Okay, nice. Then we can also go right in the same place right here and grab one of these arrows, and I can change the way it's pointing if I just drag and drop it over this way. And once again, I can also change the way that my arrow looks. I can change, you know, how thick it is. You can change what the end looks like to any of these. We can also, you know, do both sides a little bit different. So let's say I wanted there to be a circle on one side like that, and then an arrow on one side like this. All right, once again, I'm going to copy and paste and do the same thing and just kind of use these to reference different parts of my guitar over here. Okay, great. So I have already finished that part up. So now all I'm going to do is add a little bit of a word bank here below. And now I'm noticing that I don't have a ton of space for it. So I'm actually going to move up my name and date a little bit. I just drag and drop and I selected. I can move those up a bit. Then I'll move up my title a little bit, position that. I'll do the same thing with my photo down here. Move it up a little. All right, perfect. So I'm actually going to put just a little text box down here at the bottom. So I'm going to go over here to text. I'm just going to add body text. So that's going to be this third one right here. And of course, I can change whatever font it is right here. I can go ahead and choose from any of Canva's fonts that they have over on this side. But I'm going to just go ahead and stick with the one that it auto to. So I'm going to bring it down to the bottom and I'm going to type in the words that they have to choose from. All right, so I finished that up. I don't have a ton of room, so maybe I'll just do some commas between. All right, so I finished that up, and now I'm going to go ahead and make this just a little bit larger at the bottom so it's easier to read. And then we are set. Awesome. So I really like my worksheet. I can zoom out a little bit, just making sure that all the spacing looks okay. Let me just make sure it's actually in the center. Perfect. And I think I'm ready to share it. So I just go over to my share button right here and I can click where it says download. And right now it's auto-correcting to a PNG, but I actually want to save this as a PDF. So, and then I can click download and it's going to save it to my computer and then I can print it out. I can use it in the classroom. I could also upload it to Teachers Pay Teachers if I wanted to sell it. Or once again, I actually use mine in all of my online lessons. So I could upload it to my online classroom page as well. Like I said, I use all of my worksheets that I create on Canva for both my Teachers Pay Teachers store and my online classes. I teach online with a company called Outschool, where I've been teaching for 2 years now. And in my first year of teaching for Outschool, I actually surpassed my old classroom teaching salary by nearly $30,000. So if you're interested in applying to Outschool, then make sure to check out my link below, where on my webpage, I outline all the steps to apply and to get accepted to Outschool as quickly as possible. If you're interested in learning more tips and tricks about Canva, about teacher entrepreneurship, entrepreneur topics, then make sure to also give me a follow on Instagram, where I talk about things like that all the time in my stories and my posts. If you are new over there on Instagram, then just send me a voice note and say hello and tell me what kind of worksheet that you made from this tutorial. All right, so after this video, hopefully you are feeling much better about the idea of creating a worksheet on Canva. If this video is helpful for you, then please make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscription button below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.